All right, guys, today on Land Beat, we're talking about cover types in the uplands of western Kansas. If you're not from Kansas or you don't hunt Kansas, don't skip on and go to the next video because this still applies to you. There's a lot of lessons that we can learn from the upland scenario here and what you should be offering in your timbered sections in the Midwest or eastern United States. So follow along here. But in Ellis County here today, and we're in the uplands. This is a lot of elevation topography changes, and we're in the mixed prairie. So the mixed prairie is tall grasses and short grasses, combination of both of those, a lot of forbs, shrubs, and a little bit of tree cover where there's enough shade and soil to grow some of these trees. So we've got a lot of different vegetation types coming together, and that's what makes it so good. We've got diversity here, as you can see back behind me as well. But what makes this so good is because of that diversity, we have bedding opportunities and cover, security cover, throughout the entire year. The winter, the spring, the summer, and the fall, all covered because of the combination of not one specific thing, not just the grasses, not just the shrubs, not just the dotted cedar, but all these working together to create this opportunity for habitat that's going to provide that secure cover. And really, topography in these hills plays a huge role as well. So let's dive into that. Okay, back behind me, we've got a big shrub component. This specifically is a combination of aromatic sumac and plum thickets. During the spring and summer months, we've got these providing a lot of shade opportunity. You can get in them or along the edges of them and get in that shade and kind of chase the shade around. It gets hot out here. Just yesterday, it was in the high 80s for late September. So shade was a huge component that was necessary for deer to be hiding in. The cedars can provide that, but as well as the dense shrub pockets, so they can chase that shade throughout the day. In addition, during the fall and winter, once those leaves defoliate, that shrub thicket is then going to be providing thermal cover for that time frame as sun can allow to get through there. But the density, the multi-stem nature of those shrub thickets will break out outlines of those deer bedded down. So regardless, the shrub component is very important here. We've got cedar as well for a wind block during the fall and winter time frame, but also that shade component in the spring and summer. In addition to that as well, this grass component and mixed grass connecting these shrub pockets and the role of this land. Deer can still bed in this grass component and still have a lot of thermal opportunity during the winter time frame too. Oftentimes when you get high winds, this grass load will kind of shear off the top and over the backs of deer, but also with this topography and the grass load, if you've got a northwest wind, they get on a southeast side of a hill and that topography is going to break up that wind and they'll sit there and bake in the sun and warm up their body. So because of the topography, because of the vegetation components, these uplands, and specifically where all these vegetation types come together, topography come together, you're gonna have a lot of deer bedded. So back behind me is a perfect illustration of what you wanna be looking for if you're hunting out here. Now, tying this back into more of the Midwest, Eastern United States, you need to create this diversity. If you're in closed canopy timber, oftentimes you don't have grasses, forbs, shrubs. You've got pretty much trees and leaves and sticks in your understory. You need to open up that canopy, provide some shrubs, down tree structures, start to cut it. We have a lot of other videos here on Land Beat of how to create bedding thickets or that dense cover, secure cover within timbered areas. So make sure you check out those videos as well, but think diversity across the landscape in your timbered sections to be able to create season-long bedding opportunities on your property.